There are a few moments in your life that you never forget. And for me, this was one of those moments. How did I get there? Let's start from the beginning. Apart from tea and spices, Kerala also has the answers to some of the most grueling questions humanity faces today. Sure, there are a couple of large cities, but otherwise, this state is lined all along the Malabar coast by small and sustainable towns, which by the way are also visually stunning. मेरा नाम है आयुष दिनकर और मेरे मलयाली दोस्त कॉलेज में हमेशा अपने जगह के बारे में बताया करते थे. I mean, they could just go on and on and on and never stop. And rightly so. Among a few places that know how to strike a balance between modern and heritage, Kerala is no doubt among the top in the list. Maybe that's why it's the place with India's highest human development index. And that is only possible when people from the different communities live together, respecting each other. But this is not how it always was. Nambudris were the traditional feudal elite who were believed to have come to Kerala from outside. They owned large portion of land in the Malabar region and considered themselves as the holiest of human beings, the representatives of God on earth. If you were a man or a woman belonging to a lower caste, you were required to keep aloof an exact distance according to your caste. You were required to remove your upper body clothings while interacting with them and lie on ground when they passed by, in order to avoid polluting the Brahmin Nambudris. If you touch a Brahmin, the latter must at once bathe and read much of the divine books and change his sacred thread. Yes, some of the other practices were much worse. The victims, the heroic ancestors who fought against many of these social evils, were later converted into gods, or Thayyam. After a complete year of picturing myself filming it, I was finally about to see Thayyam the next morning. So I met up with Naveen from Tindis, which is an experiential travel company based in Kerala.
You're here in Kerala after a long time, right?
Yeah, finally, after discussions of, yes. I think,
I'm so happy for
a couple
that.
Of months.
Yes. We should go to the sacred groves, or we should go to the temples and, you know, see the Thayyam, get the positive vibe, or I'm saying that, the feel, and get the blessing directly.
Like you can't stage it and not something that you can do as a show.
No.
You have to go and see it only when it is happening.
Yes. So Tindis, right, as a company, like we did a research and we found more than 450 types of Thayyam in Malabar area. Mm-hmm. We will take the tourist to the Thayyam place. We follow all the custom or the rituals in a storytelling model, and they can experience the Thayyam. Actually, that is the beauty of Thayyam, and I'm getting a lot of mails and reviews. Actually, they were really happy to see this kind of ritual dance in North Kerala.
It was a Sunday afternoon. People from all around the town had gathered in numbers more than I had thought. Things seemed calm. The filmmaker in me wanted to capture the dance rituals, and luckily there were a couple of Thayyam gods already present in the temple courtyard. However, they were giving blessings to the people who had gathered there. I found out that this is something that happens after they have performed the dance rituals. So for now, I decided to just take a walk around and absorb the vibe. After about a complete 1 hour, came the moment I had been waiting for. It was the turn for the next Thayyam god to enter the courtyard. There was a god named Thamburati who was idolized by the people who lived here. One day, two new Aryan goddesses came to this region through the sea. They went to a house nearby, which was already occupied by another god, who fought with them and shooed them away. Looking for another place, the two Aryan goddesses came to the next house where Thamburati lived. Thamburati saw that the two Aryan goddesses were feverish and fearful from the fight they had at the previous house. And when she saw this, she decided to give up her own place to them and left her own house.
അപ്പോൾ നമ്മളെ വലിയ തമ്പുരാണ് പരദേവത ഈ രണ്ട് ദേവിമാർക്കും വേണ്ടിയിട്ട് സ്ഥാനം ഒഴിഞ്ഞു കൊടുക്കുകയാണ് വലിയ തമ്പുരാട്ടി നമ്മൾ പറഞ്ഞ പരദേവത ഉത്സവമായിട്ട് വന്നപ്പോൾ പറയുന്നത് എന്താണെന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ വലിയ തമ്പുരാട്ടിനെ നമ്മൾ എഴുന്നള്ളിച്ചിട്ട് ഉത്സവത്തിലേക്ക് കൊണ്ടുവരുന്നത് ഉത്സവം അത് കാവിലേക്ക് കൊണ്ടുവരുന്നതാണ് പ്രധാനപ്പെട്ട ചടങ്ങ് അതിന് കുളിച്ചെഴുന്നത്തെന്നാണ് പറയുക
There are hundreds of Thayyam rituals in the Malabar and this story is just one of them. I tried to talk to a man who becomes Thayyam. I wanted to know what happens when he gets transformed into a god from a human.
നമ്മളെ ഒരു മനസ്സിൽ ഇതാണ് ഭക്തി എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞ ഭക്തി നിങ്ങളിലേക്ക് പകർന്നു തരലാണ് നമ്മളത്. ക്ഷേത്രസ്ഥാനി സമുദായത്തിൽ ദേവന്മാർ ഭക്തി ഉണ്ടല്ലോ അപ്പോൾ നിങ്ങൾ ഭക്തിയോട് കൂടിയല്ലേ നമ്മളുടെ അടുത്ത് വരിക ആ ഭക്തി നിങ്ങൾക്ക് തന്നുകൊണ്ട് നിങ്ങൾ ഈ ചൈതന്യം നമ്മളിലേക്ക് ഏൽപ്പിക്കുകയല്ലേ
Fair enough. The next day at 4 in the morning, we went out to another village to witness one more Thayyam. And once again, things seemed calm. But today there was also an eerie vibe that wasn't there the last time. Everyone was waiting for something to happen. I noticed hundreds of oil lamps all around the temple arena. Soon, the lights would be turned off for the next Thayyam ritual. The performer was dressing up, just beside the courtyard in a closed section. His face was telling a story of being slightly uneasy and still being happy at the same time. As all of this continued, the drumming began and the lights went out. When he was ready, everyone left him alone on his own. There are a few moments in one's life that you never forget. What I saw next was one of those moments for me. It's hard for me to say if there really was a god that had descended into a human being. Maybe it was the god within him which the energy in this moment had brought out in him.
തെയ്യം പറഞ്ഞത് ഇവിടുത്തെ ഐതിഹ്യങ്ങളും ഈ തെയ്യം ഉണ്ടായ ഇതൊക്കെ കാര്യങ്ങളൊക്കെ പറഞ്ഞത്
ഇപ്പം അനുഗ്രഹിക്കായിരുന്നല്ലോ ചേട്ടൻ.
അതെ,
അപ്പം ചേട്ടന് ആ അനുഗ്രഹം കിട്ടുന്നത് ചേട്ടന് മനസ്സിലുണ്ടാകുന്ന ഒരു
പ്രത്യേക ഒരു ഇതുണ്ടാവും,
സംതൃപ്തി.
ആ സംതൃപ്തി ഉണ്ടാവും.
നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഇതിന്റെ രൂപങ്ങളൊക്കെ കാണാൻ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് മനസ്സിൽ പേടി അങ്ങനെ
തോന്നാറില്ല?
Thayam is a reminder to the young world that Kerala isn't just about the houseboats and backwaters. It's also about the new default, where the past doesn't haunt its people or leave them in shame. And it took some time and efforts for this new default to come by. But today, Kerala is a place where acceptance is a part of life and remembrance is a part of culture.
मेरा नाम है आयुष दिनकर और मैं उम्मीद करता हूँ कि आपको ये फिल्म पसंद आई होगी. दिस फिल्म वॉज डन इन एसोसिएशन विद अ कंपनी कॉल्ड थिंडिस. थिंडिस इज अ कंपनी बेस्ड इन केरला. दे कंडक्ट टूर्स एंड ट्रेल्स ऑल अक्रॉस द स्टेट एंड द बेस्ट पार्ट अबाउट दैम इज दैट दे हैव स्पेसिफिक स्टोरी टेलर्स एंड दीज पीपल आर नॉट गाइड्स. दे आर द लोकल पीपल फ्रॉम दैट प्लेस एंड दे टेक यू अराउंड एंड गिव यू अ रियल इमर्सिव एक्सपीरियंस. आई हैड अ ग्रेट टाइम फिल्मिंग थयम विद देम एंड आई डेफिनेटली रिकमेंड देम टू यू गाइज. And apart from that, I also want to thank each and everyone who has been supporting us, be it on Patreon, as a channel member on YouTube or otherwise. Thank you so much. It means a lot. See you soon.